Amuna is our future. We're here. Amuna, we're going live in all our different stories. Yes, Amuna is our future with planning and strategies. That is today's enlightening and important class. Never has there been a time where we need more renewal. Yes, this is the time, the coronavirus challenge, just making sure everything's good. Looks good to me, thankfully. Just really appreciate everybody's patience with all our stories. And we are focused on you. That's right, because our whole point, why are we doing these Amuna classes? Why are we doing our Amuna QA with Rav Shalom Orish? Why are we doing this? So we can be more involved with you. We can hear your feedback. We can work together and we can thank Hashem on a universal level, because ultimately there's the power to do something very, very profound. Yes, more profound than these things, more profound than the current crisis we're in, or strategize and plan for some sort of world takeover. No, Mashiach's going to take over. That's what Nissan Black said. But the idea is that we have to be enlivened to be able to renew our mindset, as we've been speaking about, have more self-awareness, to know who we are, to know what our purpose is, and to, through these confusing moments, to be able to go there in a way that gives us success, that's lasting, and it transforms us into a more Amuna mindset, Amuna heart, Amuna speech, Amuna everything, Amuna actions, that everything should contain Amuna. It's not enough for us to talk together on some abstract level so you hear some beautiful ideas or thoughts, but it's really important that people have an experience of internalization and application, that we need to be able to turn our tragedies into strategies, as Gedalia Fencer says wisely. And it's really important that the way we do that is by joining together on a global level. Thank God we have all these wonderful apps, and we have Instagram Live, we have Facebook Live, welcome everyone, we have YouTube Live, we have Baruch Hashem, we have our audio for our Breads of Israel Amuna is our future podcast, and thank God we have our edited weekly class, which went up very nicely last week, just the end of the week, and onto our website as well, not just YouTube. And we welcome you guys to be part of this journey. This is just our Amuna weekly class of Eli Goldsman. But even more, we have in this studio, we have the blessing to have sit here Talmid Chachamim, people who are learning Torah. There's all kinds of different classes in different languages. And for me, most of all, the most important part of the week is with Rav Shalom Orish himself. He's our host from Chut Shel Chesed, Breads of Israel. He hosts us in his beautiful studio, which is growing. And we had a fantastic class with Shlomo Katz. Wow. Who didn't feel uplifted by Shlomo Katz? It was amazing. The inspiration, the energy, the music, the soul. It was fantastic. A way of connecting. And all of you guys were there. I could feel the energy. I mean, it's gone, thankfully, over 30,000 views. And we put it up on lots of platforms. So thankfully, we're seeing it on many different levels. And that's really cool, because it's something which is giving us ability to connect into a whole new level of how we as people can join together through music, through questions and answers. And thankfully, we have wonderful Rav Elgrod, who comes here and sits right here, and he is able to translate in such a clear, professional way. And we have, thankfully, even though he can't be here the next 2 weeks, we have another beautiful rabbi from our Amuna team, Rabbi Ralph Cohen. He'll be sitting here in the next 2 weeks. And we have guests coming, thank God, like we've already had with Thank Hashem from Listen Black. And we had all the wonderful questions we had that 1 week, just focusing on you guys. And then we had Shlomo Katz, as we mentioned already, with the music, and he is now joining us weekly on a Sunday night with his live class. It was beautiful, the music, and he's talking about Rabbi Nachman and what Breath of Torah and Nigunim means to him, and it was very uplifting. I got very inspired. The miracles that are going on there through that music, through how Hashem is inspiring us all through the Ruach HaKodesh, the divine spirit that wakens a person to write music and to share that with others. It's something which personally I'm a musician, I very much relate to. That was part of my journey. I spoke about it in the classes back all the way last year, this time with Amuna is our future, with journeys and other classes around this time of year. I spoke about my journey and how music was such a fundamental part and continues to play an important part in my journey, because me personally, thankfully, I have the opportunity to join with so many wonderful musicians. Even with the corona crisis, they're able to speak. Nissan Black's doing speaking tours, as we So we came here, and please God, we're going to go ahead. But unfortunately, there has been a rise in corona in Eretz Yisrael. The corona challenge has taken on again a second wave, God forbid, and it leads us to be a little bit more careful. We have to be more careful. We do have our mask in our pocket, and we do have to be careful within our offices and who's here and who isn't, and all the different rules of social distancing, or rather we'd call it physical distancing. This is a time where we have to really take note of what the government is saying to us, not because it's politics, because it's health, and that we are aware that that makes a difference to us. So all of you guys out there, we pray that the corona crisis, this is a big thing Rosh Hashanah Morish said, we have to pray on a daily level, and we have to up those prayers on a daily level, that this whole thing should go away, this corona problem. We should only grow from it. It should give us opportunity to heal, but MS, to come to true healing. So then hopefully we won't have these kind of, you know, daily problems that we're hearing about with schools closing, classes closing, kids going into bidud, going into quarantine. And unfortunately, and that's been some people who have got really sick from this recently. And, you know, this is something we have to really pray and plan and strategize. How are we going to deal with a daily life where there's so much change now, where we do have to walk around with sanitizer, and we do have to have masks, and we do have to be conscious. And when we go into booking scenarios, for example, my specific business, or it's the tourist business, or it's whatever it is, or anything we're doing, we have to be able to be flexible and versatile. So that whatever plans and strategies we have, as we spoke about in the description, you guys can look there, you have to be able to always, at the end of the day, let go. You're not in charge. So let's first get now to the planning and strategies, so that we guys, us together as a group of, please God, of inspired people, can join some of our thoughts together and create an awareness of what it means to plan. So firstly, I want to explain, I didn't grow up with this, yeah, so you guys should know, yeah, just making sure. I didn't grow up and I didn't know about the partial of the week so much. I didn't really know about, you know, Torah Judaism. I didn't know about Daf Yomi, Mishnah Brura Yomi, and every other Halakha Yomi. I didn't know about all these things to learn Torah on a daily level. I didn't know about it. That wasn't my upbringing. I grew up for what they called secular North London, and it was cool and fun, and we had a good times back in those days. But it was like, it wasn't like the kind of vibe where I could, you know, God forbid, like make, you know, choices like that I do now in a way that I do now. I wasn't aware. And maybe the truth is people in that world, thankfully, have awareness. And in the end, there's only one world. So everyone has some sort of sharing of universal knowledge and wisdom of how to go ahead with their life. But I didn't know about these crucial parts of my soul that I'm talking about with our Muna classes. I didn't know about the Torah, the Shulchan Aruch. I didn't know that I was obligated all these things, and that I was bound. My soul was hungry for these things. Only once I stepped into Shabbos and had my first experience or anything like this, did I suddenly come alive with what this is all about. And it was really inspiring to me to finally have that kind of exposure. And I pray all the people out there who reach out to us, who want to come to Israel and Jerusalem, or they want to go to have those kind of spiritual experiences. Baruch Hashem, there's Chabad, there's online resources, we have our resources, what we can offer. And please God, you know, look, Rav Elgrod is stepping up, he's doing a Wish series. You guys should tune in, it's a new class coming. Gedalia Fenster, we just put on a class there, Tikkun Klali. So important. Who doesn't need to work on Tikkun Klali, which is the ultimate general, complete rectification that our world needs? It's a Torah from Rabbi Nachman, and it's Tehillim, Psalms, but it's a very deep concept that all of us can join in and be part of these 10 Psalms every daily level, or at least a weekly or monthly level, as much as we can. So all of us have that power to tune in to the Tikkun Klali that Gedalia Fenster talks about, and all of us can be able to draw in from such a place, such an energy. So I pray for all you guys that you should have that opportunity to listen to those classes that we put up. And obviously we have Rav Oresh's classes, and we're going to have our QA continuing with Mordechai Ben Avram. What an opportunity to bring someone like that. So this is all like the resources that we have that we're offering to help you have a more spiritual connection. But the important part is, yeah, that as much as you have that opportunity on our channels, you have to make your own plans and your own strategies, how to make this part of your schedule, whatever kind of spirituality you're tuning into. And why is this important? Why is this connected to plan? Because, for example, if you go into the Torah, you see this concept of we have a sidra, like we have a parsha. It's a weekly parsha, and we can tune in to that light that's available for all the world and for all the Jewish people to get clarification, to understand, to get that mindset, to get that purification through the Torah Kedosha, and to do the mitzvahs Hashem, which is basically a commandment to learn Torah. It's not something which is so optional, like for a man, really, it's something which is like obligational, at least a fixed amount of time. If you go to the Shulchan Aruch, it's actually Krishma in the morning, Krishma at night. You recite the Shema, it's a few parshias, maybe even the first parsha, biddy, Evan. But you have the opportunity to learn your fixed Torah by being part of that yichud, that unification. I once thought of a nice idea that the 12 hours ahead, and I had a whole beautiful class based on Stephen Covey's concept of first things first and time planning and being able to organize your schedule to know what really is your priorities. And over there I spoke about, and I talked about it and here in our Munas, our future classes as well, when we spoke about prioritization and, you know, the concept of really knowing what Hashem wants from you at this moment to organize your day, to have Seder. We spoke about the Seder night. Everything has Seder, has organization. So the Sidra, the Parsha, is also shining at us that idea of prioritization that we have to every day, or at least on Shabbos, tap into the Parsha. It's not enough just to have the Shema, and it's 12 words, the Shema Yisrael, Hashem Elokeinu Hashem Echad, and then Baruch Hashem Kvod Hakadosh Baruch Hu, we say that quietly. Those 12 words are, to me, connected to the 12 hours ahead from the morning. And again, we say at night, those 12 words are connected to the 12 words. So the idea is you're bringing this yichud, this unification of the day in of Hashem's oneness of the Shema into the day. And again, at night, you're bringing that unification. And again, every night you do this, and every morning you do this. And its concept is, that's why it's kvias, the minimal amount of learning, the kvias belev, to be able to put into your heart the minimal amount of Torah, of organization, of strategy, of planning in your day, should be that you're involved with this oneness of Hashem Echad, that you're involved with, there's one God, and you have Ol Malka Shemaim. You have this obligation to be connected to godliness in a positive way, not in a negative way. It's not like, you know, people say, you know, I hate going to work, and I hate doing this, I hate doing that. No, this is an obligation you want to be part of. You want to be part of this obligation. It's enlivening and inspiring. So we're just going to end this on the Instagram Live. I apologize, guys, because it looks like we're not going to have enough power anyway. So every week's a learning process. Let's get this moving. Great. So we did that. Yeah. Okay. Okay, it is what it is. So we're going to make sure that you guys, please God, have the opportunity to tune in on a daily level to what we're doing. And that's why we always try and put a little bit of Parsha into what we're doing. It's very important that all of us have that opportunity to tune in to the Parsha when we're learning Amunah classes, when we're learning anything. We should try. And thank God, you know, there's so much resources online, how to get that light of the Parsha. That should be part of our strategy on a weekly level, that we should have a kavias, a fixed amount of learning. And I would say that the Chumash, the Brashi, the basic level should be there. Everyone should know. Right now, it's Parshas Pinchas. We talk about the Parsha. Everybody's holding there today. We're all in the same place. Everyone met up together in a global level. We're all tapping into the light of Pinchas. Pinchas has within him the Chagim, the holidays, the festivals. And Pinchas is also the thought of the future. It's something I mentioned in the notes below, that we should try plan ahead. What does it mean to look forward? What are we looking forward to during these next 3 weeks? How can we elevate this next 3 weeks? So we're about to enter on Thursday. Please God, it should be a day of joy, but if not, it's a day of fasting, and we end it with Tisha B'Av after 21 days with another day of fasting. How do we go into this time period? How do we understand? So Hashem arranged the parshas, yeah, with the Rabbonim's help, how to read into the Torah a certain light that gives us that inspiration. So now, when we're going into our daily life of business and work and family and hassles, and please God, we should be saved from, but if people have to deal with it, we're dealing with the hospitals and the doctors, please God, we should take those tests, those situations, and we should elevate ourselves, that we shouldn't get pulled down by the daily grind of life. We have to, where are we going to get this elevated mindset? So like I'm saying, go into the Parsha, go into Pinchas. This is Pinchas has in it, this week's Parsha, tremendous light. Pinchas Zu Eliyahu, he's Eliyahu Novi. He has in it the light of Mashiach. If you look in the Parsha, there's so many hints of this. Brisi Sholem. When we spoke about Gedalia with Tikkun Klali, what is Brisi Sholem? There's the idea of the Kedushas of Bris, to have Sholem, to have peace. Everyone wants peace in their home. Everyone wants harmony. Everyone wants to have a feeling of oneness and joining up with other people. I myself believe that the next few weeks I'll be working on a collaboration album. It's the last time you guys can send in your album. Shlomo Katz is even sending a song. We should be able to tune in to that idea of collaboration, of unification, of oneness we spoke about again and again. And comes Brisi Shalom. This is the key to make that oneness through Shalom. And how did Pinchas make it? We know it's a complicated parsha to understand exactly how he made Shalom. But it was the idea was he was doing exactly what Hashem wanted him to do. That's the clear point. And that brings Shalom to the world. I'm a Kohen myself, or maybe even a descendant from Pinchas. This idea, my name actually, Hebrew name is Eliyahu. So this idea of Eliyahu Eliezer, two names, but Eliyahu is connected to Pinchas. This idea, this light of La'asid. He was a light. Eliyahu Novi is the one who's going to announce the coming of the Messiah. So we have in this time a tremendous power to tune into the light of La'asid, the light, the awe of Oro Shamashiach. These are these 3 weeks. There's a certain awakening of Chochmah Bina Das, these 3 weeks connected, those three beautiful divine attributes of high wisdom, of something that's beyond, a mindset that's so high that unfortunately in exile becomes hidden. So we don't see the full greatness of these 3 weeks. We don't see how these three Shabbos coming up are really opportunities to tap into the hidden holidays that are within these Shabbos. And that's why Pinchas starts off the 3 weeks with the reminder of the festivals, that this time of mourning is really within, is hiding a greater joy. And that's to understand when you're planning ahead that you have to have a little bit of a elevation, a little bit of spirituality. And that's what you're going to get by, on a strategic level, learning the Parsha. It's not something which is just like boring or dry, God forbid, or something that was. It's happening now. And not only that, it's talking about what's going to be. It's prophesizing. The Torah is a prophecy. The Torah is an elevated oneness with us and Hashem, a relationship. He's communicating to us. And that is a very important to understand when you're strategizing about your week, what to do. You have to have, I personally, I have a time where I tap in, like we said, to the Shema. We have to say Shema, we have to say Talis, Tefillin. We have to do all the mitzvahs the way it should be. Shachar is, we should wake up with the right cleanliness. Go through the day, go through your what your emotions are. Personally, I don't try go ahead with anything until I read the Parsha of that day, that Aliyah, as Chabad say, and go through the Rashi hopefully as well, and read the Shtayim Michas Arches Targum to go through what it's written in the Torah. So you're tapped in, as the Chabad Rebbe and his Talmidim said, you're attached into the daily diary of Hashem. He's communicating to us through the Torah. We have it set up that it's aliyot, 7 days a week. We can tune in. And then comes Shabbos, like Stephen Covey talks about this idea of the seventh habit is to review, sharpening the sword, to review everything that you've done, all the hard work you've done during the week, those 6 days, the six habits. Then you come to Shabbos and you have the seven aliyahs, these seven attributes, and you go over them in the shul, because you're already prepared. It's not just coming to shul and just hearing someone read something that you're completely not connected to, but just because you have to. That's not the kind of obligation I'm talking about. I'm talking about an obligation which comes from love, comes from oneness. You know, look at Rav Oresh, you see the way he loves Hashem and he loves other Jews. There's a certain emunah energy, a oneness with this truth and spirituality that should be so palatable, if that's a word. Yeah. So you guys correct me, I don't mind. The idea that we should be so tangible what we're doing, that spirituality, when you learn the Parsha on a daily level, that would be a strategy every day. And we said other things. Personally, I say Psalms every day. Connect into some Psalms, some Tehillim. So get a little bit of David HaMelech in your day. Personally, I say every day and I finish once a month. My wife, she should be well, my soulmate, she finishes once a week. Unbelievable. She's been doing it for I don't know how long. And personally, all these things I've been doing since I did tshuva, since 18, 19. So that's over 20 something years ago. So, Baruch Hashem, on a daily level. Personally, I then take a little sefer, or thankfully now we have email, so it comes into my email box every day, a little bit of Tanya, and I finish the Tanya every year. So, Chassidish sefer, other people take a look at Maron, look at Halachas, take something that you relate to and connect with, and you, that day, on a daily level, should be part of your strategy to keep yourself in a spiritual, elevated mindset that we spoke about the last few weeks, to have more self-awareness. You have to learn these kind of things that uplift you and give you insight into your soul. How can you not learn about your soul? It's the most fundamental part of your being. Everything you do, it's food. Like you eat physically. You see people go to restaurants and they fress. You should be fressing on Torah. Yeah, I mean, obviously everything in balance. Yeah. Remember, I'm talking about small amounts over here. I'm not obligating everyone to learn Daf Yomi, which I also try and do with my son. You know, that's personal. And I also try to learn halachas of tefillin right now with my son, and my other sons try to be an example, remind them of the mitzvahs that they have to do. And as a chiyuv for me as a father, it's this obligation, as hinuch to mahanich, to educate my children in these things. And in the end, they'll make their own choices, just like I did. I didn't grow up religious, and I chose it. So let's pray that they choose rightly. But please God, you know, that everyone can strategize and plan for what they need to do, so they're constantly filled up in the day with positive things, so they're not only fixed on things which is basically, excuse my language, but shtisim, stuff that's like just gonna come and go, like the news and the politics. It just comes and goes. Nobody really needs to know what Trump is saying every day. It doesn't really matter that much, unless it's something which is ramifications on a practical level. And thankfully, I have those sources personally into my email box, so good as well. Other places, they send me a few news networks that I only really focus in on, and I try not to get caught up in the Twitter feed when I'm there posting or whatever I'm doing online, social media. Try not to get pulled into all this craziness going on, time wasting. We have the opportunity, all of us, to strategize how to use our day fully so we have a positive and uplifted way of living. And then comes this crisis we're in, and we're on a different daily level. We're already ready. We're already equipped. We have our armament. We have our tefillah. We have our prayer service. We have and it should be 3 times a day. And like Rav Oresh says, the spodidus, we should be talking to Hashem 10 minutes to an hour a day, how to get rid of this coronavirus, how to get rid of all these negative things. We should have our weapons of spiritual war, how to equip ourselves so we're not falling into all this time-wasting stuff that's going on, and it doesn't lead to anything fulfilling. There's so many people right now who are feeling lax, who are not feeling uplifted, who are feeling down. You hear from Gedalia Spencer's classes and the questions, you know, the things people are struggling with, stuff that thankfully I left myself. I left all these bad habits when I was a teenager, thankfully. And I was able, hopefully, I'm still doing tshuva on that. But Baruch Hashem, I'm 20 years and I don't have to be involved in any of that stuff. And thankfully, it leads to so much more energy. It leads to a feeling of fulfillment that I know I'm doing my purpose in the world. And there's nothing more that God can ask from me. Obviously, I can improve myself and I can become a nicer person and I can be more insightful and I don't waste time, because I'm not perfect, I do waste time, and all these things I'm talking about. But you have a strategy and a plan, so overall your day is set up that you're accomplishing and you're growing in spirituality and you're growing in finding more in touch with, making these things relevant for you. The Torah should become relevant for you, and that's what I did with Pinchas, for example. He was Brissi Sholem. He was the one who made the Torah relevant for his time. He took away all the negativity that was going on in that moment, and he gave of himself to the people. And that's what we're trying to do on our Muna Tor channel. We're trying to, please God, go out there, go and face all the internet craziness like that was going on. In his time, was the women came and tried to get the men, the Jewish men, to do Avodah Zorah and do Averis with non-Jewish women. And for Jews, that's not our purpose. And what do we do now? We have to go onto the internet and we have to make sure that we're not doing Averis with all the craziness on the internet, all the pools and all the things drawing us in. We have to go into that space like Pinchas and Mace Brissi Sholem. We have to be really strong in what we're doing and believe in it. And the only way we're going to come to that is by really believing in ourselves. And that's why, for example, we're bringing Mordechai ben Avraham tomorrow night. And we're going to sit here, and please God, when this is edited, you guys can watch it again. We're going to have him, a Rav Shalom Arush, and they're going to sit together, and he's going to ask questions to the Rav. Very important questions. I hosted him Shabbos, Baruch Hashem. It was a beautiful Shabbos, him and a friend, and it was very uplifting and inspiring to be with him, and he hopefully was inspired a little bit about what we spoke about. But the idea that we should tap into ideas of the future reminds me of something I wanted to say, which I think is something which needs thought, and I welcome your feedback on, and we'll end on this. But the idea that making all these concepts and plans and strategies, for example, there's many things you can get involved with. For me personally, I'm always wondering and thinking, you know, like, you know, there's a whole women industry of singers. It's something which I thought about, you know, because I haven't done so much with. There was one woman singer I thought about working with, it didn't really work out yet, or for whatever reason, very talented. And, you know, I had a concept, You know, you want to go ahead into strategy, you have to pray to Hashem to give you the right strategies, the right plans. That's another important point, planning and strategies. Not only do you have to organize your day that there's room for the times for spirituality, but you also have to ask God to what you go into business-wise should be the right strategy and plans. And with that awareness, you might have to let it go completely anyway. That's the whole point. So for example, with this woman idea, I had this, you know, how to get women singers into a more business-like format and to be able to get them more involved in the Jewish music industry. They're already trying, obviously, but you know, to step it up, maybe do a collab album with them and this and that, try different ideas. I don't know how it would work with Chutzpah Chesed and Brazzaville. I mean, these are concepts. So you ask Hashem to guide me. I don't know. You know, in the end, it's a good idea. You know, these people have talent and expression and art, but how to do it in Lefi Halacha, if you guys want to get into it, you know, there's people online. You can message me, and if you have questions about it, because it's something I'm thinking about, I'm talking about, it's the discussion is worth it, because the concept is, until you get all the pratim laid out, like the Shulchan Aruch, a clear table, until everything's laid out, all the different pros and cons, same with any business you're going into, get the facts, get the figures, don't just make an investment. Someone reached out from investment, I sent it to a guy who's a lawyer in that area, and he said, I've never seen anything like that, so then it's the end of it. So each thing, you have to have advice, good advice, and make sure you're surrounded by people that you can trust and people that you know that they want only your best. And these are kind of things that, you know, as our Amuna channel on Torah goes, we are open to your advice. We're open to our community to be interactive. That's why we want to hear your questions. We want to hear your feedback. We want to work together. Not everything you say, we're going to agree with, honestly. You know, that's our choice as, you know, people working here and making this happen. But we can still hear it, and it does affect us in a positive way. And that's the idea, same with business. And every level, everyone out there needs to be more flexible. Things are changing. The world's going through a lot of transformation. And all of us need to be on our toes a little bit more motivated, a little bit more energized, not wasting time on rubbish now. This is not the time for it. It's game over, the Netflix binging days. That was like maybe the beginning of Corona when we first thought this was, we didn't know what was going down. And even then, we shouldn't have wasted our time then. But now is the time for action. It's time for real contemplation, for real strategies and real plans, what our life's about. It's not a joke. Serious stuff going down. The world's being woken up. Go look to Alan and other. Serious stuff. And we got to keep a smile on our face also, even in the seriousness. Enjoy life, I walk outside and I look at the sky, and they say there's nothing better to get rid of this corona than the sun. There's nothing better than just a healthy immune system, as Joe Rogan talks about. There's nothing better than just keeping your body and soul and emotional state in a good place, to eat well, to sleep well, to do exercise, to have healthy lifestyle. This is part of strategizing and planning for the future. Because you want to have a future, you've got to be there in one piece. There's no point killing yourself for a job or killing yourself for some cause. You've got to be able to be a balanced, healthy person. And then the cause will flow in a healthy way with divine providence, that Hashem guides you and will give you the means and the ability to do what your purpose is in the world. And that is my planning and strategies class, to get the spiritual side of your day set up so your week prepares for Shabbos, for your week prepares for the Yom Tov, for the 3 weeks that is coming up, that we should turn it into a Yom Tov. We should strategize and look towards the days of Mashiach. Like Shabbos Chazan is a time where we visualize the third base of Mikdash. We're coming up to those special times where we can visualize what's going to be like in the days of the Messiah, where the world will come to Yom Shekula Shabbos. Have those visualizations of positive. Have the visualizations, please God, of people dancing together again and being able to have warmth and love in an express way, and obviously in the right way, but doing it in the right way, in the right time, without any worry of any disease or any of these kind of problems. But in the meanwhile, while there is this situation, to be versatile, to go into your strategies and planning with an openness to let go. You're not in control. You're not God, as Gedalia always says. You're not God. And as Rav Arush himself says, pray and pray and pray. Pray for an end to this corona story. That is a plan in itself, that we have to pray for it to end, so then we can be fully free to use all our time and energy in the healthiest, happiest way together, to learn, to grow, to want a life of positivity, and to make it happen on a daily level through connecting ourselves to God's Torah, to the love of what it means to have a soul, and to be able to be part, please God, of this oneness, this unification that we're talking about, of Emunah is our future, that our future will be filled with Emunah and positivity. Amen. Thank you for joining us this week. Sharon, please.